Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss all the important questions from Evans, Trice and O-Level. The writer is Colin Dexter. So without wasting time, let us start with question number 1. What kind of a person was Evans? This is a very important question and here you have to write first point, habitual congenital leptomaniac. Evans was a habitual congenital leptomaniac. 4 times he broke the jail in the story. He was master planner. Therefore, now and then he was out of the cell. Very sociable and exhibitionist, because of which he earned all his friends. He was a pleasant chap to whom everybody loved. He was non-violent. There is no record of violence in jail's diary. He was excessively intelligent. Question number 2. How do you account for the fact that Evans selected German only for his O-level examination? Why he did not choose any other subject? The reason is that out of other teachers, Evans had good rapport with the German tutor. Point number 1. Point number 2 is because of their friendship, the tutor could have been instrumental in his escapement. Okay. Question number 3. Why was Evans known as Evans the Brake by the prison officer? It is because he was habitual jailbreaker. 3 times already he had broken the cell. And he was planning for the 4th time now. Okay. He was planning for the 4th time. Why do you think Evans does not become conversant with German in spite of having been taught for more than 6 months? Point number 1 is, tutor had to explain simple German expressions meaning that is Guten Glück, which means good luck, before the examination. He did not know meaning of simple word. Okay. So tutor was an accomplice of Evans. They were planning for escapement. Learning German was a non-issue. So, with the help of German teacher, Evans was planning for escapement and they were not learning anything. Okay, they were not preparing for the examination. Question number 5. Who were the 2 visitors Evans received in the morning of the day of his examination? Here, at 8:30 a.m., Mr. Jackson, Senior Prison Officer D. Wing, and Stephens, newly recruited Officer D. Wing, were there in front of Evans. Question number 6. How far do you think Jackson is justified in his apprehension that someday Evans might cut his bloody throat? This expression was told by Jackson and let us find out the answer. Jackson misjudged him because Evans cannot commit suicide at any cost. Because he was practical minded and perfectly planning, criminals like Evans can never commit suicide because they have a way out for any problem. They outsmart their authorities and gain freedom. With those insignificant weapons, they have made their plan successful. This is what we have seen in this story. Question number 7. Knowing fully well how sharp Evans is, shouldn't Jackson have told him to remove his bobble hat in his presence? Point number 1. Jackson is credulous and gullible. He thinks if hat is lucky, then he should wear the same. But this is the blunder of Jackson. Because of soft corner, he allowed him to wear it. But because of which Evans was out of the cell 4th time. Evans used that hat to hide his clipped hair to impersonate McCleary. Okay, he had to look just like McCleary. Therefore, he used that hat to hide his hair. Okay. Evans' character analysis is superb. Psychological insight, keen sense of observation. He analyzed the governor, Jackson, very properly. Therefore, he was able to make escapement planning in a very successful manner. He knew that what will be the next move of Evans and Jackson. And he knew that Jackson has a soft corner for him. Therefore, if he will ask for the permission to wear hat, he is going to allow him. Okay, let's continue. Question number 8. Why do you think Jackson asks Evans to remove the pin-ups from the cell? Pin-ups means pictures and photos of attractive persons, particularly film star and models, etc. Jackson knew that a person is going to visit the cell. Okay? Such pinups will be unpalatable and unbecoming. Therefore, he asked him to remove singer's photograph which was hung in the wall. Question number 9. Why did the governor instruct Jackson to search McCleary? He might have brought weapon sort of things unknowingly which Evans could use for his escapement. He might have used for killing somebody. Therefore, governor asked Jackson to search McCleary thoroughly. Let's move ahead. What explanation does McCleary give about the rubber ring? He had piles or hemorrhoids. He cannot sit continuously at one place. Therefore, he brought semi-inflated rubber ring to help himself with sitting continuously on the chair. Actually, it was one of the device for escapement. He had brought pig's blood, in order to accomplish their planning. And this is the pig's blood which he put on his head and face in order to make the planning successful. And because of this only, prison officer thought that it was McCleary who was injured by Evans. Okay, but nobody was hurt. It was pig's blood which he had brought from a butcher. And in order to preserve it from coagulation, he used some chemicals as well. This also shows that how intelligent Evans was. Next question. Who do you think made a call regarding a correction in the question paper? What did it really meant to convey? Students, at 9:40 a.m., the governor received a call from the assistant secretary with a special responsibility for modern languages regarding correction in the question paper. Presumably, it was an accomplice of Evans or friend of Evans. After the prison, Evans and McCleary will go to Hotel Golden Lion. This was told over the phone through the correction, but it was one of the plannings of Evans with his friends. Okay, it was not a genuine call. Because Evans had friends everywhere, therefore, here also in the examination department also he had got one. He was the one to make a call to the governor. Okay, let's move to the next question, number 12. What significance would you attach to the supposed phone call from the magistrate's court? Was it genuine or just a ploy of Evans' gang? First of all, it was not at all a genuine call. It was a hoax call. Okay, it was made to mislead gullible governor, which demanded a prison van, a couple of prison officers also in connection with the remand case. A call was made from magistrate's court which asked for a van and few of the prison officers. Okay, and it was not a genuine at all. It was needed for the final escapement. And if you have read this story, students, you must have understood that from where the van arrived. It arrived because prior only the arrangement was done. Call was made from magistrate's court. Okay, it means Evans had friend here as well. Okay, and the officers, the original officers, they might have been tied somewhere, and whoever were there in the van, they were the friends of Evans himself. Okay, let's move ahead. Why did Stephens did not report the matter of Evans wearing blanket in the cell? Point number 1. In between intervals of 1 minute, Evans was changing into Parsons' dress to look like McCleary. Top collar and the black front of the dress kept slipping off the stud. To conceal this, he wore blanket. Stephens thought he was continuously feeling cold in that area. Actually, Stephens thought that D wing portion of the entire prison is very cold. Therefore, maybe Evans was feeling cold, so he was wearing blanket. But this was another blunder of Stephens, because he was not feeling cold. Rather, he was making himself into the gate, into the appearance of McCleary to deceive entire jail fraternity. Question number 14. 3 minutes before the examination was to be over at 11:22 a.m., there is a call for Stephens from the governor. Is the call genuine? What is the underlying idea behind the call? First of all, it was not a genuine call at all. That was not made by the governor. Idea was to take Stephens away for some time to enable Evans to give finishing touch to his makeup so that he looked like McCleary. Okay, students, before 3 minutes of the completion of the examination, there was a call to Stephen, okay, from the governor, okay, according to the writer, from the governor. But that was not made by the governor. It was somebody, some friend of Evans who made a call so that Stephen will be away from the cell, and in that few minutes he will be able to make himself just like McCleary. Therefore, he had taken that time, and this was the plan that Evans had made along with his friends. And then we see the governor later on, when asks Jackson and Stephens that why did they let McCleary go, leaving Evans in the cell, then they said that it was his instruction, whereas governor did not make any call at all. Question number 15. A photocopied sheet had been carefully and cleverly superimposed over the last pages of the question paper. What was its real purpose? Students, first point should be, final details of the plan was written on those photocopied sheets. Next point should be, it was also left to make authorities believe that the wounded man was McCleary. It was written that Evans should not hit McCleary so hard, and he will not make too much of a Scottish accent, okay? Therefore, it was a plan to deceive governors and jail authorities. So these points you will write. But it was left deliberately by Evans so that the governor will come to hotel after searching him. Okay, it is because he wanted to befool him once again. It was in plan to get all those officers in the... Jackson is really a moron and careless enough to mistake a stranger's voice on phone to be the governor's discuss. At first, you have to write, an officer who is an important part of the prestigious Oxford prison should have his eyes and ears wide open and shown vigilance. Next point, his mistaking a stranger's voice on the phone to be the governor's and calling Stephens excitedly shows how immature he is. He really is a moron playing into the hands of the master planner. Question number 17. By presuming that Evans had kept the clerical paraphernalia hidden in the cell, what obvious blunder is the governor committing? First point, the governor still took everything at its face value, still thinking the thoughts fed to him by the criminals. It is surprising that even he, the most seasoned officer, does not doubt the antecedents of McCleary and fails to come to the conclusion that McCleary is an accomplice of Evans, and it was he who has smuggled in the clerical paraphernalia. So students, it was McCleary who brought everything for Evans. He wore two coats. He got everything two numbers. It is because it was very appropriate for him to get, because Evans could not keep anything inside the cell. Okay, so but governor is thinking that Jackson did not check his cell properly. Let's move ahead. Is the governor justified in considering Jackson as a stupid person? No, not at all, because even the governor became victim of the criminals. He wrongly believes that Jackson had searched the cell carelessly and failed to notice the clerical paraphernalia and a weapon hidden. Okay? In spite of strict vigilance, how did Ivan's friend manage to give the material for disguise in the cell? Ivan's friend, disguised as McLary, the invigilator, managed to smuggle the disguise material into the cell with ingenuity. He came wearing two person's dresses with black fronts and collars, brought an extra pair of spectacles with pebble lenses. All these were passed to Ivan's when Stephens was away from the peeping hole. Next question. How did the governor manage to reach Ivan's in the hotel? Finally, he realized it was Ivan's who went out. The governor realized it was Ivan's who went out. He was impersonating McLary. He saw the index number and located the place in Ordnance Survey map for Oxfordshire. He reached the hotel. Ivan's entered the room pretending to be caught. He was waiting for the governor. Actually, he was waiting for the governor because all those clues, all those proofs were kept by the Ivans for the governor. Okay, it was intentional decision of Ivans, and it was not the intelligence of governor which brought him to the hotel of Ivans. His plan was to further befool the governor. Now, why did he do it? He did it so that he can befool this governor and other authorities once again. So without breaking a lock, he was out of the cell now. By this, we have completed all the important question answers. I hope this is going to help you out. Thank you, students.